Ozark Highlands Radio is brought to you by the Ozark Folk Center State Park in Mountain View, Arkansas, a wonderful way to enjoy yesterday. On the web at ozarkfolkcenter.com.
Howdy, folks. This is Dave Smith, host of Ozark Highlands Radio. This week, we'll be listening to music and interviews from a young lady who does a wonderful job of interpreting old-time ballads, songs, and music, our own Grace Stormont. Writer, professor, and historian Dr. Brooks Blevins profiles the Brockwell School and its tradition of education in the uniquely American art form of shape note singing. And I'll take a trip down to the vault to visit with Mark Jones and listen to a musical gem from the past. All that and more this week on Ozark Highlands Radio. Recently, when I emceed the Mountain View Bluegrass Festival, I noticed a young lady sitting quietly in the wings just off the stage. I didn't have to look twice to know that it was young Grace Stormont. She's a familiar sight backstage at the Ozark Folk Center. While lots of other girls her age are riding up and down the strip or sitting at home with their eyes glued to the screen of their device, Grace can be found memorizing the words to an ancient ballad, practicing her banjo frailing, or sitting in with one of our performers on stage. In just a few short years, she's become an audience favorite here at the Ozark Folk Center. Here she is with a set of tunes, starting with Ireland's Green Shore.
Started taking guitar lessons when I was 13, and I already knew that I liked to sing because I was in choir in junior high. So I just put the two together, and it just worked for me. I had a passion for it, and I always wanted to learn new things. It was just something I was passionate about, and I knew I wanted to do it for the rest of my life. I think what I love most is getting up and performing in front of people, because I have confidence whenever I get on stage that I guess I don't normally have, because you actually get a reaction from people. They'll clap and they'll hoop and holler, and I like getting up and performing, and I can just be myself on stage, and I don't have to worry about what people think, because for all I know, they're from somewhere else and may never see them again. Decided I wanted to start making money at what I was doing. And so I came up here for a summer job, and we moved up here originally for 3 months, but we ended up staying because I loved the music so much, and I told Mom, I refuse to go back. I have to be here. And so I stayed, and I learned, and What drew me here was basically just the music, and I really like the people here too. They've taught me a lot, and the Music Roots program, I enjoyed helping out with that last year. That brought me up here too, because I thought that was so cool, and I wanted to be a part of it somehow, and so I helped out with that.
Darling, please tell me true. wonder why we live and why we die? Do you wonder why we laugh and why we cry? Do you wonder why we dance and why we fall? And tell me, darling, do you wonder these at all? And tell me, darling, do you wonder these at all? Like a child who can't wait to go and play, I am waiting for love come my way. Can we make this new love feel like an old shoe? Tell me, darling, please tell me true. Tell me, darling, please tell me true. Tell me, darling, please tell me true.
Thank you.
I play a variety. I play a little bit of older jazz. They're kind of like show tunes, some of them. I play old time and I sing ballads, alternative folk, maybe. Alternative folk is little hints of, you know, the traditional folk music, but they throw in rock and roll, jazz, pop music even. They'll throw in everything into one type of, one genre, and that's sort of what makes alternative folk. And that's how I describe my music. It's the old-time music that really speaks to me as a songwriter. I do. I feel like it comes from old time and the ballads. That's what I've listened to for a year now. So hearing it, I think it's what is influenced me the most out of any other genre that I hear. It's not easy for me to talk to people after the show. Like whenever we have to go out and shake hands, it's hard to socialize, but to just get up, it's like a performance. I don't necessarily have a script, but sometimes I'll have the things in my head that I want to say on stage, and I'll get out there and I'll say the stuff that I want to say. And if there's something in my head, it just pops up, I'll just spout it out, and sometimes it's hilarious and they'll laugh at me. And it's different being shy, because people expect you whenever they walk up to you to they'll expect you to be sassy or something, but you're just so quiet and reserved and they don't know how to take you sometimes. And sometimes people think I'm stuck up because I'm so quiet. But I've recently gotten better at talking to people. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now, but I won't be worried long. I went across the river to lay down and rest. Went across the river to lay down and rest. Went across the river to lay down and rest. And when I woke, there were shackles on my feet. Takes a worried man to sing a worried song. Takes a worried man to sing a worried song. Takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now, but I won't be worried long. 15 lengths of chain around my leg. 15 lengths of chain around my leg. 15 lengths of chain around my leg. And on each length, the initial of my name. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now, but I won't be worried long.
That was young folk singer Grace Stormont singing Worried Man's Blues. Grace started that set with Ireland's Green Shore, followed by Darlin' Corey, Tell Me True, and The Scarlet Tide. After a short break, come with me down to the vault and we'll see what my old buddy Mark Jones has been up to. You're listening to Ozark Highlands Radio. I got to thinking that it's been a while since I've been down to see my friend Mark Jones, down in the vault. We've been recording music here at the Folk Center since we opened up in 1973, and Mark's the keeper of all that old music down in the vault. Let's go down and see what he's found for us. Hey, Mark, are you down here?
Dave, yeah. How are you doing?
It's been a while. I'm
doing
pretty good, but man, I hardly found you. You're back in the shadows here. You need to get better lights down here.
That's true. We do, don't we?
Yeah, man, you got a lot of stuff down here, though.
Oh, I do. I tell you what, I run across a recording of in 1973 of the Junior Rackensack. And this is all the local kids that go to different schools and all. Each school would send a group of students in, and they would play on the show here at the Folk Center on Thursday night, right before the festival really kicked off.
That's right. I remember that. Some great shows, too.
They were. Would you mind listening to some of these? They're just a lot of fun to listen to.
I'd love to hear that from 1973.
Yes, sir.
We have Miss Morris's third grade, Miss Jimmy Driftwood's third grade, and they're going to sing an old song Jimmy's made famous, and they're going to sing about Down in the Arkansas. Come right on out, kids.
Slobber bad down the Arkansas. I took him to my great granddad down the Arkansas. I asked him what to do for it down the Arkansas. Grandpa's to teach a cow to spit down the Arkansas. Down the Arkin, down the Arkin, down the Arkansas. The sweetest girl ever saw was down the Arkansas. I knew a man, his name was Jack, down the Arkansas. He had a hawk called Razorback down the Arkansas. The strangest thing you ever hear down the Arkansas. He used that hawk to shave his beard down the Arkansas. Down the Arkin, down the Arkin, down the Arkansas. The sweetest girl I ever saw was down the Arkansas.
Show you cotton, corn, and cane. Show you every kind of grain in my happy little home in Arkansas. Come see me, neighbors, come along. I'll bet greet you one and all. Tis the finest country found. I will show you all around in my happy little home in Arkansas. Take you out into the orchard where fruit is on the tree, in a land where big red apples grow. Their delicious smell of sweet, you may have all you can eat in my happy little home in Arkansas. Come see me, neighbors, come along. I'll bet greet you one and all. Tis the finest country found. I will show you all around in my happy little home in Arkansas.
There was some great singing there, Mark. Weren't some of those third graders?
They were, Dave. Third graders and different grades. It's here. And, you know, Dave, I got to thinking about it, and I bet me and you have taught a lot of their kids on you teaching guitar and different fiddle and different instruments, all the things that you teach, and me teaching banjo. I bet we've taught some of their grandkids.
I'll bet we probably are teaching some of their grandkids right now. Maybe more than that.
Maybe so.
All right, good to see you, Mark.
Good to see you.
Arkansas has been home to at least three famous ballad singers: Emma Dusenberry of Mena, Almeda Riddle of Heber Springs, and Ollie Gilbert, who lived here in Mountain View. Our featured guest, Grace Stormont, is working to keep alive what many fear to be a dying tradition, that of the ballad singer. Let's listen to Grace's rendition of Mary of the Wild Moor.
On a cold winter's night, as the winds blew across the wild moor, poor Mary came wandering home with her child, till she came to her own father's door. Papa, oh, Papa, she cried, come down and open the door, or the child in my arms will perish and die from the wind that blows across the wild moor.
watchdog did howl, and the village bell tolled, and the wind blew across the wild moor. Oh, how the old man must have felt when he came to the door the next morn, and he found Mary dead, but the child yet alive, clutched close to his dead mother's breast. Now the old man in grief pined away, and the babe to its mother went soon. And no one, they say, has lived there to this day, and the cottage has been left to ruin. Now the villagers point out the place where the ivy grows over the door, saying there Mary died, once a fair village bride, from the wind that blows across the wild moor. From the wind that blows across the wild moor.
I started working at the Folk Center, and there was a lady, Mary Gillihan. She came up to me and she said, "Your voice would just be perfect for a cappella ballads." And Mr. Scott, the stage manager, he said the same thing. And so they both gave me a cappella ballads, and I performed them on stage, and they just sort of stuck with me. I really liked how they told a story, and you didn't necessarily need anything going on behind it. You didn't need chords to be strummed or anything. You just needed to hit your note and just start in and tell a story with your voice. It's really cool to me.
And I don't
a big fan of Abigail Washburn, and I always wanted to play the banjo, but I wasn't exactly sure what style it was or what exactly she was doing. But when I moved up here and I heard people doing the claw hammer, I knew I could learn it from someone up here, and so I went to Miss Shea and I said, hey, I want to learn this claw hammer banjo stuff. And so she taught me the basics and showed me how to do it, and I helped her out with music roots. We did fifth grade banjo last year, and a big influence for me was I listened to Sarah Jarose, and she does a lot of, she'll play the melody while she sings. I try to do a lot of that, and it just, it makes the melody stand out more.
The moon so brightly was shining, the grass already damp with the next morning's dew. While under the starlight I wander down an old beaten path that I once walked with you. I thought of our days spent together, and I thought of your smile and the touch of your hand, of how I wept the day that you left me and your dear soul departed to a new peaceful land. And although I'll never wake to see you lying beside me or feel your warm embrace, I know you're singing with angels and your sweet soul rejoices in that beautiful place. Years ago we made a promise to stick with each other through thick and through thin. Darling, we kept that promise until dying you whispered, I'll meet you again. I was crying right there by your side, dear, when the angels came down for to carry you home. We buried a lily on your grave and then journeyed on home. And although I'll never wake to see you lying beside me or feel your warm embrace, I know you're singing
I think I'm more creative out of sadness. Because when I get sad, I have to do something to cheer myself up, or else I'll just be sad all the time. And so I'll sit down and I'll write something down, or I'll write about how I'm feeling. Like if I've been through heartbreak, I'll write about that. Or if I miss someone, or if someone's passed away, I'll write about that. And sadness is just something that motivates me to write for some reason. I don't know what it is.
That was 16-year-old Mountain View, Arkansas singer Grace Stormont. In that set, Grace sang Mary of the Wild Moor, Caleb Meyer, In the Beautiful Place, and a song based on Edgar Allan Poe's Annabel Lee. When we come back after this break, historian Brooks Blevins will profile the Brockwell Singing School and the tradition of shape note singing. This is Ozark Highlands Radio.
Looks like he should be in pads and a helmet, protecting a quarterback on some manicured Southeastern Conference field, but his massive hands and fingers frolic along the keyboard with the dexterity and unpredictability of mice in a late winter hayloft. He sits grinning through a goatee at the main piano, thrashing away at a tune he had never seen before yesterday, a new melody branded with the echoes of jangling strokes on pine walls and sunburned voices in two-door meeting houses. 20 feet away, perched formally atop the second piano's bench, like a downy owl peeking from his nest, a wisp of a boy accompanies his massive partner, The lad's eyes burn a hole in the songbook. His petite hands move effortlessly across the keys, a water bug on a summer eddy. No wasted movements, no change of expression on his face. Two masterful musicians bound to be ignored. The voices in this auditorium are what matter most. That becomes clear when the singing starts. The silver-haired song leader peers over tiny spectacles, chops the air with her right arm, swings it to her left, to the right, and back up to its starting point, and we are off. 6-year-old sopranos, 80-year-old tenors, teenage wannabe basses hold their paperback songbooks as instructed, out from the body in one hand, the other is for leading, and follow their respective parts. The tenors lead, me, me, do, me. Half a beat into the second measure, everyone else joins in, each section following its own line. Shape notes the first time through, followed by three verses of a newly minted song called A Godly Man. It will likely never appear in another songbook. Once the new books arrive for next year's school, it may never be heard or sung again. But on this day, A Godly Man reverberates throughout the cinder block auditorium, 100 voices in four-part harmony, or something approximating it. This is, after all, only the second day of singing school. Folks have been doing this on North American soil for the better part of 300 years, and with shape notes for 200. They've been singing and learning the do-re-mis at the Brockwell Gospel Music School in Izzard County, Arkansas for 70 years now, with no signs of stopping or slowing down. The second oldest annual gospel shape note singing school in the country, one of only a couple dozen in existence, the Brockwell Gospel Music School is a little-known treasure of the musical scene in the Ozarks. The Brockwell Gospel Music School was founded in the summer of 1947 by Orgel Mason and the Izzard County Singing Convention. Like almost all the young men of his era and place, Mason came of age in the Depression, facing little more than the prospect of following in his father's footsteps as a poor scratch farmer on the rocky hillsides and narrow creek bottoms of the Ozarks. But an itinerant singing school teacher at the rural Methodist church his family attended opened up a new world to young Mason. Eventually, he found a mentor in Luther G. Presley, a songwriter and singing school teacher who maintained an office in Pangburn, Arkansas, for one of the nation's leading gospel songbook publishers, Texas-based Stamps Baxter, the company that would publish the popular Heavenly Highway hymns in the 1950s. Mason completed Stamps Baxter's normal school in Dallas before launching his own career as a singing school teacher in the late 1930s. A colorful man who also served as a sought-after piano tuner in northern Arkansas, Mason developed a keen ear for the tones of the shape note gospel style. Like most veteran shape note singers, he prided himself on his ability to pick up a new piece of music and sight-read it with near perfection. "You give me a brand new song today," Mason told me in an interview back in 1993. "I look to see what time it's written in, and if it's shape notes, I get my pitch, even without instruments, because I've sung them so much on that staff, and then after I get my pitch, I take off from there." Today, the focus of the singing school remains the same as it was in 1947, the rudiments of reading music and singing the do-re-mis. The Creekside campus has expanded from a single tabernacle in the early days to a cluster of 5 buildings. The length of the school term has been reduced from 3 weeks to 2, and the school has shifted from its original July after the crops were laid by scheduling to mid-June. But much remains the same at Brockwell. Like generations of students before them, children at recess and lunchtime continue to wade the shallow creek in search of crawdads. The youngest ones delight in being chosen to tramp the campus grounds, ringing the cowbell that signaled the end of lunch break back in the days when it was still called dinner. Despite the informal atmosphere, leisure is in short supply. Even beginning students spend about 5 hours per day in classrooms and in the auditorium, studying music theory, learning to keep time or direct songs, and doing ear training by listening to the different pitches on a piano. The more difficult lessons, such as chords, chromatics, and songwriting, are left to intermediate and advanced students. It is from their ranks that the next generation of singing school teachers and singing convention leaders will emerge. As the folks at Brockwell get ready for their 71st annual school, let's go back in the hills to Brockwell, Arkansas, to listen to Orgel Mason and a gospel quartet sing It's a Mighty Hard Road to Travel.
It's a mighty long road to travel, and a mighty long ways to go.
This week, we've been featuring 16-year-old Grace Stormont of Mountain View, Arkansas, a fine young lady with an ever-increasing repertoire of traditional songs and ballads. In this final set, we'll hear her sing Shady Grove, A Rovin' on a Winter's Night, and the great old hymn, Rock of Ages.
This is called Shady Grove.
Peaches in the summertime, apples in the fall. If I can't have the girl I love, I'll have no one at all. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Wish I had a banjo string made of golden twine. Every tune I'd pick on it, I wish that girl were mine. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Well, some come here to fiddle and dance, some come here to tarry. Some come here to fiddle and dance, but I come here to marry. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Well, fly around my pretty little miss, fly around my daisy, fly around my pretty little miss, or you nearly drive me crazy. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, well, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Wish I had a big fine horse, gonna feed him on. Shady Grove, but staying home and feed him when I'm gone. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, well, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Blooming rose and eyes are the prettiest brown. She's the center of my heart, she's the prettiest thing around. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, well, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, well, I'm bound for Shady Grove.
Separates me from people my age. People my age are getting jobs at fast food restaurants or grocery stores, normal jobs. They're getting normal jobs and where they probably make more than I do and work more than I do. And it's probably more strenuous work. And they think, oh, all you go do is play music and have fun. But they don't realize that there's a whole other aspect to it where I have to work out all my songs and find the right arrangement for certain things. And it's just, I think differently than a lot of people my age, I think.
Good. It's about time somebody else was besides me, I tell you. All right, go ahead.
While roving on
I don't think I can go a day without picking up something or playing or even singing a little bit, because it's natural to me, sort of like breathing is natural to someone. It's something I have to have, or else I don't know, I can't carry on. It's what I do when I'm sad, it's what I do when I'm happy, it's what I do when I'm stressed. It calms me down, it mellows me out, it makes me feel better. It's like good medicine for me.
Round, round, wanna go around, wanna see the rock of ages. When my body gives out, gonna read the final pages. Oh, my mother who's gone, she told me I should meet her. Someday streets of gold gonna guide me home to see her. Round, round, wanna go round, wanna see the rock of ages. Till my body gives out, gonna read the gospel pages. Oh, my father sat down and told me of the prophets. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, they're gone but not forgotten. Thank you.
That was folk singer Grace Stormont singing some good old traditional songs. I hope you enjoyed this week's show. Don't forget, you can find us anytime at OzarkHighlandsRadio.com or follow us on Facebook, too. You may have noticed that we started this show off by ringing a cowbell. That's because we use that same bell to start our live shows here at the Ozark Folk Center State Park. If you're planning to visit us here in Mountain View, drop us a line and we'll arrange for you to ring the bell to start our live show. For all of us here at Ozark Highlands Radio, this is Dave Smith. See you next week.
Ozark Highlands Radio is produced by Jeff Glover. Executive producer is Darren Dorton. Additional support for this program comes from the Committee of 100, proudly supporting the Ozark Folk Center State Park since 1974, and by Arkansas State Parks, with 52 unique reasons to visit the natural state. More information online at arkansasstateparks.com. For information on upcoming shows and events, we are on the web at ozarkhighlandsradio.com. Until next time, I'm Donna Farrar.